Welcome, dear friends. Okay, nice to see you all on the boat. So, after quite a long time, we are interacting live. I would request Lokesh to give the link to our DFMs, discussion forum monitor, that moderators, that if they can spare the time. So, welcome, Shweta, Bharat, Naini, DB Jani. So, sir, how to address comments which are not to be possibly ruptured by the authors, rebutted by authors? You know, I have addressed this thing, DB Jani. I will write directly come to the point and the discussion for discussion point of view that you will have to be very specific when you are answering the queries. Okay. Don't try to, you know, distort the facts. Just be true. If something is lacking in your part, admit it, and you should be very honest when you are answering the things. Okay. So if you can, if you are completely unable, until unless you have done some blunders, if you have done the blunders, you will have to admit nothing can be done. But if some weakness is there, you can admit that, you can do it in the future work. Okay. So welcome on board all the learners. Increase your sound level. So you need to increase my sound level. Just a minute, hold on. I will do it. Lokesh, I'm again increasing. Am I audible properly now? Yes. I think this is okay now. Yes. So friends, good morning. Now we will move from good morning to good afternoon. Whether it's better that we go directly to the questions, especially when we are having the assignment extension. I think I have already given quite sufficient time. If you haven't submitted the assignment one, you are free to submit the assignment two. Okay. Because and still you have time up to 25th of April. So either you do one assignment or first assignment or second assignment, both will work. Any one you will have to do. Okay. Yeah. Pardon. And look if you can in a reduce your voice. Second assignment is not submitted. what you have to do that you can write in your, you know, it's an article, you can write in your mobile phone only also, you can do, doesn't matter, and you can upload it, you can do it lot many things from phone itself, and not more. I think we have just asked for 800 words article which can be written. I just published one of my article in within 20 minutes, 1000 word it was, and it's published. Just I in note of the mobile phone, I published that I wrote that particular article. Please do it. So it is a hard time, you know, in the hard time, your actual potential is analyzed. And as far as the date extension is concerned, sorry, we would not be able to extend the date because very soon the second cycle is going to be started. So we have already evaluated the assignment one. We have already evaluated the assignment one. Now it is our time to go for rest of the thing for the second assignment. Okay. And being timely is another lesson you have to learn in the academic writing, because if you are unable to submit author's comment in a particular time frame, if you are unable to submit you are unable to submit proofreaded material, sorry, you will lose the academic writing. So timing is very important. Exam date is, we have earlier mentioned to you that it has been postponed so far during the lockdown condition. Very soon you all will be intimated. Okay. Assignment one link will not be opened, Shweta, obviously, because assignment one date is over. You cannot submit the assignment one now. Okay. So better you go for the assignment two. Okay. You can skip the assignment one and it will work. It won't affect your marks because we will be having best of two. And if you have done one, the one assignments will work. Okay. So there is no issue. You need not to go for each and every time for the assignment one as well as assignment two. Even if you submit only assignment two, it will work. No issue. Okay. will be the exam be objective? Objective, obviously, please mention it. You can see it in the discussion forum top part. Objective questions will be there, 100 questions will be there, and the question will be obviously from the all the weekly quiz or daily quizzes. Okay, it will be from there only. मोबाइल में क्या नहीं हो रहा है? मोबाइल में अटैक नहीं हो रहा है. लोकेश, आई कुड नॉट गेट इट. पटेल, पटेल जागृति है, अटैच नहीं हो रहा है. फाइलेट इज व्हाट यू डू व्हेन यू डोंट गो फॉर द दैट ऐप वर्जन. यू गो फॉर द डेस्कटॉप साइट, देन इट विल बी अटैच श्योरली. ओके, यू यूज द डेस्कटॉप साइट वर्जन. Top three of your screen, when you will log in into the SWAM, top three dot will be there. Click there and use desktop site version. It will work certainly. Okay. Exam date decided. Exam date is not decided. Vinita, I have submitted first and finishing second. Very good, Vinita. That's the spirit. What is the research gap? You know, research gap is about the problem. You know. Why you are doing the thing? You have to identify that why you are doing the research. This is the research gap. You have to identify that gap. Until you identify that gap, the research is nothing. Without aim, no research can be done. Is there any other course? There are so many courses you will have to explore. I will let you know. Especially in this time, Harvard University and in Coursera, in all the platforms, courses are freely available. You just have to explore, please. Sir, explain about, give some samples of research proposal as a beginner. Research proposal as a beginner, I will try to procure, because research proposal is a complete idea, you know, and no one want to reveal that particular idea that what they have done. So I will try to put it, okay? Raja, what the way we should calculate the internal mass. Internal mass we have mentioned. Please go through at the top of the discussion forum. Discussion forum, I have mentioned it. It is 30% will be there. 20 marks will be taken from the average of all the quiz, weekly quizzes. And 10 marks will be given from the subjective assignment. One subjective assignment. Okay. So if you are given two, we will be taking the best one. If you are given one, we will be taking that only. For the, okay. This will constitute your 30 marks. And the 70 marks, 70% weightage will be taken from the external marks. Okay. Explain about ATEL use in references. You know, Shyam Sundar ji, ATEL use is used in when the number of authors are more than 3 or more than 6. Okay. It depends on journal styles that sometimes after the third, if you have more than 3, if you are three authors, you will not use ATEL. If more than 3, you can use the ATEL after the first author, but it depends from journal to journal requirement. Okay. Lokesh, wrap me up some, because I'm missing some questions. Sorry, because the questions are coming too early. Whatever is before me, I'm uttering it out. So Lokesh will is helping me out from the back end. I'm great fan of you. Thank you. Any software or vocabulary which help to avoid plagiarism? Yes, Lokesh. Grammarly can help, obviously. Grammarly, but plagiarism, for plagiarism detection, you know, very good. We can discuss that thing, that go for the Grammarly. Even you can inbuilt, you can put the Grammarly into your desktop site or in your email, so it will correct your languages. Okay, I recommend that thing. Because it's quite freely available. Okay, to go, when will be the final exam? Final exam has been postponed. I don't have the idea that it will be decided by the MHRD. And how many questions? 100 questions. How much time? Exam section, 3 hours will be there. These things, basic things, have been given. Research gap. I think I have answered that. Research gap is. It's a repetitive question. I have answered, please. And those for repetitive question, if you want to have the answers, you can go for the recording, because this recording will be available immediately after the finishing of this webinar. And if you will ask in Hindi, I will reply in Hindi. And if you'll ask in if whatever the language, you know, the language is no bar. So don't worry about the language. Okay. Scopus Index journal ideas, you just go to the Scopus Indexing. Okay, SCI ke website mein jaiye, go to the SCI website, you will have the Scopus Index. Don't rely on the journal that it is claiming that is Scopus Indexed. Okay, you can have the list of Scopus Index journals. Atel, I have Shyam Sundar ji, I have, I think it is repeating, Lokesh, plagiarism in footnotes. Plagiarism in footnotes, no, footnotes are exemptions, because when you are using the footnotes, say for example, statistical significance percentage is there, like p-value is there, so you can claim it that, you know, these are the standard practices, okay? Because exemption criteria is there, you will have to make it exemption. If your paper is there, if your paper is there, you will have to claim that it is my paper, so it cannot come into the definition of plagiarism. So what is the API? How institution mark any faculty on API? API is academic performance indicator given by the UGC in government, by the government of India, and it has got, you go to the 2018 regulation of the UGC. It is available in the UGC website. Each and everything is well defined there. Okay. Rational the study, the rational is telling that why you are doing. Significance is what is expected basically. Why? There are more or less similar, but the difference is certainly there. Rational is why you are starting it. Okay. Significance is what kind of you know importance it is having in terms of when it will be done, what significant change it may bring. Okay. These are the different things. Okay. As far as the citation style or that writing reference style is concerned, you are advised to just copy the particular, just adopt the style which is recommended by a journal, by authority in which you are for which you are writing. Okay, and it is not like that this reference style is good and this is bad. All are good, and all have the different domains depending on their subject disciplines. So we cannot say. So depending on your utility, you go for that particular style only. Okay. I think this was the question, isn't it? Hanuma. No. UGC sponsored major research project available not now. You just be in touch. It was the DST. UGC has given this task to Impact. What is that? Impact, which is being dealt by the BHU, and the windows are, I think they are opening the window twice in a year. Okay, you just go there. So, and for DST also opens the window twice a year, and it has just closed for the CRG, core research grants. It has just been closed, and I think our proposals are also being processed there. So you will have to be in touch, you know. If you are having any idea related to COVID-19 related, I think the window is still open. You can submit the proposal to the DST SERB. Okay. What about the research output? Research proposal is, it is like just like applying for a loan. When you are going for applying for a loan to the bank, you will have to give the pros and cons of your idea when you are. So in the same manner, if you are going to get the fund from there, you are each and every subject, each and every line must have the importance. You cannot write like writing a synopsis for a thesis, because you are going to get the grant. You will have to be very precise in origin of idea, rational of idea, your plan of action, your methodology, and the novelty. These are the 3-4 things which are very important when you are writing the research proposal. And each and every grant agency has different set of you can say that proposal form. Okay, so you will have to go through that requirement. Well, theses are all, because theses in Indian perspective, theses are uploaded into the Shodh Ganga. So when they are uploaded into Shodh Ganga, they are supposed to be Creative Commons for fair uses, but you cannot reuse them completely, because if you will reuse them as such, it will be a case of plagiarism. You can use those datas, you can use those references for your studies, but you cannot use it for your credit. Okay, Creative Commons is not allowing you to have the work copied and reuse it by your name. You will have to attribute. Attribution is the first and foremost thing. you will have to attribute. You cannot claim that it is yours, even if it is Creative Commons. Don't misunderstand the things. It doesn't allow you to use it as it if it is yours. Okay, remember this thing. Yeah. API style you can use. We will try to give some videos or suggest some videos. There the inbuilt scenarios are there in your Microsoft. There the styles are given. You will have just. Mendeley EndNotes Zotero Litter and go to the Litter and Management Tools. When we are talking about the literature review, in the last module, I think we have given the literature management tools and two chunks are there on the these two things. Okay, EndNote and Mendeley we have discussed. Please go through. We have discussed the things. Okay, so you will have to go through the videos. Computer-based exams is not possible from home because the exams are supposed to be proctored exams. And yeah, one thing I would like to let you know. I think I have mentioned in a particular email that you can go to the NTA site and you can have the mock test. However, the mock test is not available for our test. You can go for any test like Arpit course, you say. You can give the exam as if it is the actual exam. So you will have an insight that how it works. So I will again float that particular link. I think I have, as far as I remember, in one assignment I have given this that particular link. I will give it to you again so that you can have an environment or that mock test you can practice, which is practiced by the NTA for giving these SWAM MOOCs exams. Okay, I'm not doctorate yet. Can I get the grant from until unless you are faculty member, you cannot get the grant. If you are a faculty member, you can get the grant. Doesn't matter you are PhD or not. You know, I got my grant. Though I recommend you to take an supervisor. You can be the PI. You can be the co-PI. But I think being PI without PhD, it's a typical task. Okay, but it is not mandatory. However, you will have to see the guidelines of the different agencies in which agency you are targeting. Okay. But no student, no research scholar can get the grant directly. This is clear. Which is the best software to check plagiarism? You know, best is depends on your availability and the availability of money in your pocket. Okay. Alternative SPSS, but recently used, which are used in social sciences. Lokesh, SPSS ka alternative. R is the open source software, isn't it? But R is not user friendly. मुझे तो समझ में नहीं आया R. You know, to be very frank, मेरे को बहुत समझाने की कोशिश की थी. JNU के एक professor है. He was here as a resource person. So I was scratching my head in the entire lecture, but I couldn't get the thing. SPSS is very 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 user friendly. Okay, so this is the beauty of the software. You know. Origin we used to say. However, we don't use the Origin for the social sciences kind of research. We use it for purely science research. But Origin has very good features and very user friendly. So you can use the Origin. Okay, and I think Origin, statistics. You can give the link, Lokesh. You can type the link for the our learners. Okay. Saint Mary, and I would like to let you know, if the light is gone, I don't have any backup. Okay, so the streaming will go off. So please pardon me. I could just manage the thing. The entire department is no. I am the only one in the department sitting for you only. Okay, and there is no backup for me. So, Anita, if you are faculty, you can, even if you are not PhD, you can go for the even for the PG colleges. I think they give the masters. They give the grant up to 5 lakh for the sciences and up to 3 lakh up to 3 lakh to the arts and humanities still, I think. Okay, but the grant, but the proposals are taken only when the call for proposals is open. Okay, it is not open for around the year. Yeah, remember this thing. Okay, anything else? Thank you Artha. Introduction to flow, you can write the flow comes with the confidence. Flow comes with your, complete clarity in your mind. No, I can talk slowly only because I am having the knowledge. Okay, that flow comes only when you have enough knowledge, precise knowledge, you can summarize as well as synthesize the thing. So you have to please go to the cohesion and coherent part, which we have discussed in week two. Okay, week two, I think day three. So you will come to note what is cohesion and coherence. Just adopt the cohesion and coherence. You will be able to write if this is simplicity is the best. You know, the, in the life, the most complex thing is to simplify it. You know, it's the most complex. Put it in the very simple term, to present in simple term is the most complex thing. Simplicity is actually the most complex thing in the life and in every domain. And it holds true in the academic writing. Okay. Yeah. Any alternative software to for formulation design? What kind of formulation? Design expert is the thing. Design expert is the for the software design, software related. Okay. And apart from example, JNPSAS, okay, based on menu selection process to run the code method, but in R you have to, of course, Naini, thank you for answering the things. When we'll start to write synopsis, what main things should be, you know, synopsis ke liye we have exclusively given a part of the thesis writing. When you'll go to, I think, week 11 here, I would like to raise your query, which are not addressed in the, you know, our course. Okay, so if you are good at programming static R, but I am just an application user, I need the application. Main kisi app ko use kar raha hu, it doesn't mean that I should be able to know the programming to develop the app. I need an app which is user friendly. That's why R may be very good, R is very good, but sorry, not for me. Okay, if you are good at programming, take it. How to write a catchy proposal to get approved by postdoc panel. You know, you will have to be very convincing, very crisp, each and every subject. Dr. Rauf Ahmed, but it is a very good question. For postdoc, you will have to be very, very convincing. First, whether your research proposal is matching with the research area undergoing into that particular institution or a particular group of that institution, number one. Number two, think or not. Number three, whether you are capable and are you showing that particular thing that I have that metal which you require. You will have to show it, okay? In minimum words, not with the vague comments, just with the supporting evidence of your publication, of your work, okay? And you will have to be very, very crisp in putting the problem area, research gap, and rationality and novelty of your topic. Okay, I think I have mentioned it. Thank you, Shyam Sundar ji. Thank you so much, sir, for nice information. Okay. Video streaming is tracking. You know, it might be in your part, Naini, because I think I am using the one of the fastest network here available. Okay. And that's why I'm able to use the streaming. I think no other will be having the problem. In other areas, poor internet connectivity is issue. I have come to my department for getting this connectivity. Thanks to Government of India, at least in and MHRD, at least we are being provided that particular high speed internet here. JNPSAS is related to pharmaceutical formulation design. So what kind of you are asking, Dinesh, how to any kind of formulation design? So any kind of I'm not having, you know, this kind of information, but Lokesh, as per the Lokesh, is saying that any kind of designing you can do there. How to get your paper published in Scopus Index journal? You know, it holds true for the rules. There are no thumb rules, you know, in academic writing. You will have to be very crisp, very very, you know, effective. It is not a particular key which unlocks the Scopus Index journal publication. Okay. Maybe it may be there. Please suggest the word limit and format for the subject assignment. Go to the instructions. I have mentioned 800 to 1000 words, isn't it, Lokesh? We have mentioned the word limit. Subject assignment, please go through the instructions. Okay. Obviously, Bharat, the issue is there. It is there, and connectivity issue is there. The speed is the issue there. I want to postdoctoral research in music. You should ask your, because I am not an expert of music. You know, I may give you the insight of the things. I may show the way, but I may not have traveled that way. Okay, it's like the same thing. So though we will try to answer your question. Okay, while the research paper has used references of any other person's work, and I got info from the reference, there should be I use first reference, which is original one. Or secondary one? Sorry, I couldn't get your Gunjan question. As used reference of any other person. It is called cross-reference. Cross-reference, you know? It is called cross-reference, you know? It is, yes, you can take the thing. It doesn't matter. Whatever you like, you can take both of them, or which is the most suitable one or most relevant one for you, okay? Those who are having the problem in interconnectivity, because it is being recorded. So you can see the recording afterwards also, okay? It would be visible for you. Again and again, you can see. So suggest some alternative or SPSS. We have discussed it. The streaming freezes. Yeah, so you are... No. Academic writing. No. It's not, you know, UGC doesn't say any course is equivalent to that. If your university, it depends on the university, what you can do, the faculty members can go with that thing that they can pass this subject as a PhD paper. So then the credit will be given. Okay. So it is the duty of the faculty members who are there on board in our course, that they can get it approved as a PhD paper of 4 credit. Or 3 credit, whatever. Even if it is providing 4 credit and you allow it for 3 credit, you will be given the 3 credit. No issue. Okay. So it's on you. You can put it in your BOS and get it passed. And many universities are going to do it very soon. Yeah. In reference, do we need to cite the most popularly cited one or the latest on the references we have sent? It should be a good mix of the latest references, historical references, and the most relevant references which are relevant with respect to your discussion part. It is a high time. You please focus on the writing, as I have mentioned in a particular message. And please don't forget, I have exclusively made a live webinar section in our course. You go through the webinars in this cycle, the webinar which we have conducted in this cycle and the earlier cycle, both we have kept in that particular section. And some extra materials we are going to provide. So keep on checking. We keep on updating that particular unit. Okay. So you can get. And this webinar will also be included in that unit again, so that you can get it for your reference. Okay. Research in cinema. And I want to analyze films. What research methodology will be good? Will be good to add? You will have to, it depends that you will have to go through the research hub. Aap aisa kijiye ki film study se related, what you can do, that you can go to the OER Commons and go to select your research hub related to the film study and see what they have done and collect the different cases and try to analyze them. That research methodology, you can explore that. Okay, Bharat? Our course, Dr. Satish, our course is not, so far is the part of ARPIT. It is a simple MOOC with 4 credit, and if any college, any university takes it to a BS, it will be 4 credit course. Okay, and soon we are in the process that most probably from the next cycle onward, it will be a FDP, maybe if government allows. Okay, should we be taking permission writing of for each and every reference we take in our literature review of PhD? No, you need not to take the permission for when you are writing the reference. You need not to take the permission until you are taking some part from a particular source which is copyrighted. You should take the permission. Okay. Leadership with what research methodologies act for it? Appropriate for it. Okay, appropriate. In the leadership, you are doing the research in leadership. You want the research methodology. Research methodology should be, again, the same. I think the answer will be same. first case studies. You will have to go for the case studies, analyzing those case studies and taking the and forming a particular questionnaire and survey based, you can see, and float it to the private industries and government sectors to have an idea and essence of that what you want to go. And it depends on what is your hypothesis, what you want to do actually in your research. It will work only. Okay, so there is no simple formula in each and every research. You will have to blend that thing with so many components and present it in the unique way. And this is the way we do the research. Okay, has opened a new era for creating MOOC in Swayampro Hotel. Is there any particular issue to be in the team? You know, to be in the team, you can develop your MOOCs. I have mentioned in the week last week that you can develop your MOOC, you can develop your proposals and apply for the national coordinators. You can develop your own. You need a good team. And if you want to be the part of our team as a discussion forum moderator, Dr. Shweta, Dr. Ellery, Dr. Subhiksha, are almost 6 to 7 people who were the toppers of the last cycle are with us, will helping us in the discussion forum as a discussion forum moderator, and that too completely honorarily. Okay, so I am very thankful to our discussion forum moderators who are giving us their valuable time for answer your queries in the discussion forum. Without their support, it won't have been possible to answer your queries. Okay, yeah. Dr. Satish, for you go to the Commonwealth of Learning, CUL, ka website se aapne kiya course. You go to the Commonwealth of Learning, a lot many material will be available on this Creative Commons. Okay, and there is a exclusive site, those who have created this license, Creative Commons. Go there, you will get each and every material regarding Creative Commons. Okay. On a particular topic, we cannot give a plethora of the knowledge in a particular section only. And we have given the further links there. Please go through those further links and those websites. Okay. Credit mentioned this course count for our API score. No. It's not for API course. It is for if for a particular university who have taken it as a part of a syllabi. For those students, it is the this credit belongs to those people only. Can I learn data analysis? You know, data analysis is an exclusively different field. That's why we have touched it, because it is entirely, I think, in academic writing 2.0, we'll plan these things in data analysis, obviously. Okay. I belong to law faculty, so generally we go through doctrine research. So will it be considered first by Scopus? Or do they have prefer only empirical studies? Nahin, empirical study ko har tarah ka studies hai. Just you go for the case studies, you go for the your Supreme Court decisions, and decisions are available there like case studies you do. So what, I don't think so, there's a problem. Yehi kehna cha rahe hai, main samjha nahi baat ko puri tarah se. Ya to generally we go through. Doctor says, will it be considered by Scopus, or do they prefer only empirical studies? No, you go to the journal styles, and whatever their expectations, you can go ahead. It depends on journal to journal. We cannot generalize the things. Okay, it 12:32, my dear friends, and 1 o'clock the lockdown time will be over. So I am having only 10 minutes for you now. I have submitted an assignment. Can I submit it? You can go for the second assignment. No issue. Please go ahead with the second assignment. Okay, and weekly assignment, at least weekly quizzes you must do. You must do if you want to get the. And if you won't get the 40% marks, I think out of 30. Okay, if you don't get the 40% marks in internal, you won't be able to get the certificate. Please note it down. Okay, so you have to get minimum 40% in internal as well as minimum 40% in external. Then only you will get the certificate. Okay. Data science courses are very popular from edX Coursera. Yeah, of course. UGC, ye to hamari taraf se bola ja raha. Okay. Very good. You can go to the edX and Coursera. I have mentioned you this plethora of courses are there. Even the Harvard University, I would like to again mention that so many courses are there available. John Hopkins online courses are freely available. You just may go there. And this is the high time, you know, utilize this time for your lockdown time for your writing. And I have also mentioned, in I think in that announcement email, in the introductory email, the 9-10 that links of ICT initiatives and OER of by the UGC, MHRD and Government of India, I have mentioned, I have communicated to you, share with all your friends, colleagues, and do not forget to give your feedback about the course. We'll be happy to get your feedback. I think it's the link is now open, as I have told by the feedback team. So you please go to that feedback link and give your feedback. We would like to, we'll love to have your feedbacks. Okay. Now, as the time is going on, I would like to have, I would like to conclude the session, but you can have just one, two questions we can have. Even NPTEL also, data science or engineers, Python for data science, learning and so on can refer. Obviously, NPTEL is also having good, good courses. Quizzes, you know, if you will complete the all the 15 quizzes, the 15 quizzes will be normalized to marks 20. Okay, 15 quizzes mean 1500. It will show 1500. Actually, it is percentage. We will take only 20 marks out of that. Okay, whatever you score, so you can have an idea. Sir, when I'm working some descriptive research, which research method should be applied for analyzing of resources? For research in international relations, please elucidate. देखिए descriptive research आप जब करते हैं research method, which research method should be? Descriptive research जब भी हम करते हैं ना it's a kind of hurricane task because each and every component, each and every parameter must be identified very well and quantification is very typical in that way and you will have to refer good quality resources for that descriptive research until unless the expert supervisor you cannot have that thing. Okay. The role of supervisor is always very crucial. Role it is not just supervisor, it may be any mentor. Okay, it may be any teacher. So you must identify a good mentor on the basis of their H index, on the basis of their role in research, and follow them. So certainly the person will help you. Okay. We have to do only one subject assignment for the two given assignments. No, you should do the both of them. But if you are able to submit only one, then no issue. The marks you score in that particular assignment will be taken to the for the internals only. Okay. So mandatorily one, but expectation is two. So thank you all. Now I would like to sum up the things and the all the whatever the other questionnaires are there. All weekly assignment are compulsory to be submitted. Weekly assignment are not compulsory. If you the even anything is not compulsory, if you don't attempt any weekly question, doesn't matter at all. You can give the question, you can give the you can register for your exam, but you won't get, you will not be getting the certificate. So for learning, it's free. In learning, nothing is compulsory. But if you want the reward of your or recognition of your work, whatever the time you have contributed in this course, I expect, and it is very easy. If you'll give that, it will hardly take 30 minutes of to complete all the assignments. And the last assignment I'm going to release in a day or two. Okay. Gunjan, please take up my question for table. Okay. Lokesh is replying you, Gunjan. Because I skipped your question, sorry, because the screen is moving up, so I'm unable to pick and choose each and every query of yours. So Lucas is helping me in back end. I am in contact with him. So friends, what I recommend again, that utilize this time in your academic writing, take your pending work, do and write good articles, review articles, research papers, and plan the research proposals. Faculty members can plan the good research proposal at this particular time point. And they can have their notes, they can develop their open educational resources. What we have done recently, we have done in our university, which is our host university of this course, our HNB Gadwal University, which is a central university. We have developed a repository, academic repository, in which all the faculty members and research scholars are contributing a lot. And we have more than 1000 subject specific study materials. We have given the links. It is a platform in which you can go to the swayamhnbgu.in. Lokesh, please give the link. swayam hnbju.in /repo, you can see that we have, you can create, we have established that academic repository. So it is very suitable for those who are having the poor connectivity, because each and every subject specific material will be available there, and you can filter it depending on the subject. So you can prepare that kind of academic repository for your institution, and you can recommend. And soon I think it is going to be mandatory for each and every institution. But we have been, luckily, to the best of our knowledge, we are the first one to develop this kind of repository. And it will be helping your students if you are a faculty member. And even if you are a student, you must have a good open education resources which will be helping you out when you are going into the academics or you are going for the lectures. Okay, I am in hurry now. It is already 12:40. Registration starting date I mentioned exists. Registration starting date will be revealed or will be declared by the MHRD, Ministry of Human Resource Development, and the SWAYAM team. Thank you all. Thanks for being with us. And I really enjoyed your company. I was also missing you all. It was a nice interactive session. And you please share whatever you have learned, the links with all your peers, all your, you know, horizontal and vertical dissemination must be there if you want to go for the actual learning. And learning is about the sharing. If you keep it with you, it will gonna be obsolete. So keep learning. Happy learning. Thank you, guys. It was a very nice day. Thank you, Lokesh, and thank you our discussion forum moderators for being with us. It was a very nice experience again. And I think I request you that when the registration will be open, I request you all to appear in the examination. We will again make a history that our course is going to be number one again in the entire SWAYAM MOOCs. So hoping for your contribution, hoping for your support for the maximum registration in the exam. Okay, thank you. Happy learning.